Good morning. Today is Thursday, June 4th, 2020. You can hear Ellie. Yeah, she's back eating her food and drinking some water. So as I have said every day this week, I'm sharing something that I see with awe and wonder. That's to go along with this week's theme in the Google Classroom called The Wonder Of. All the teachers went a slightly different route with it, and they all invite some thinking and some writing work, and I encourage you to work on some of those exercises. So today what I'm going to talk about is the awe and wonder of the human mind, and specifically its capacity for empathy and perspective taking. Yeah. So right now I have the ability to think and understand what someone else is feeling. I understand that Hayden wants my attention. And so she's getting in the camera. And she likes to be a part of the things that I'm doing. So she likes to come to morning meetings. So I let her. So, like I was saying, we know that empathy is being able to think and feel and understand what someone else is feeling. Similarly with that, and that is useful in so many ways, in relationships, in having compassion and for other people in the world. It's important in social justice and why we take action for things that are important, because we see how they affect other people or even people that we are close to. So along with this, I want to share with you guys a couple of mindfulness practices to not practice empathy necessarily, but perspective taking. So I've utilized this book, Growing Up Mindful, a lot over the course of the morning meetings that I posted online for you guys, and I thought this one was really cool. So I'm just going to read to you from the book. It says, "The breath and body are great shortcuts back to the present moment, but we can also use our eyes to help us become present and increase our awareness and our perspective." There are three short visual exercises. You can choose one, and I encourage you to pick one and try today. So find a spot to sit, and this one is called Samurai Eyes. So sit in a comfortable position and look around the room that you are in. Examine it very closely and carefully. After you think you've had enough time, close your eyes and try to reconstruct what you saw in a mental image. And then when you open your eyes, see how close you were. See what things maybe you missed or forgot or, yeah. There's also the exercise called Child's Eyes. And that, I think, is a really useful perspective to take. Yeah, you've got an owie. I know. You fell and skinned your knee. Child's Eyes tells you to look around the room, but with a beginner's mind, as if everything is new again. This may be a room, and this is probably a room that you've been in a lot over the past few months, and you feel like you know this room really well. But part of the challenge of taking on Child's Eyes and seeing things from a different perspective is trying to find something in this room, this familiar room, that you've never really noticed before. And lastly, there's Artist's Eyes, where I encourage you to gaze around the room. Ow, Hayden, that hurts. Please, you bonked my head. Ow. I encourage you to gaze around the room and pick an object to focus on. And instead of looking at the object itself, I want you to notice the space around it. artists call this negative space. So instead of looking at, like for example, the plant, I'm going to examine the space around it and the shapes that that makes. And that's a cool mindfulness exercise. Okay, well, we're clearly done for right now. I hope you guys have a great day, and I really encourage you guys. Sixth graders, we're doing math word problems today at 2. This is the last week of that. And Friday is our whole class meeting at 1:30. We're going to do a whole class discussion and activity, and then take time to share work. So if you guys have questions, let me know. Yes, let me know, and I'll get back to you pretty quickly, as best I can. So have a good day.
Bye! I miss you.